Welcome to your yoga practice. It's going to be very gentle and brief and delightful. So starting in a cross-legged position or any seated position that makes you feel cozy and comfortable. Drop your shoulders away from your ears. And then placing one hand on your belly and then another hand here by your rib cage. And then we're just going to start with some delightful belly breaths. First going into the ribs and then into the belly and then out from the ribs and then out from the belly and then into the ribs and into the belly and out from the belly and out from the ribs and then into the ribs and into the belly and out from the belly and out from the ribs and final time into the ribs into the belly and out from the belly and out from the ribs. Just keeping your eyes closed, placing your hands either facing up to receive more energy or down on your knees to ground yourself more. Just set an intention for this time that you're spending with yourself. Maybe try and do the class with your eyes closed as much as possible. And then we're going to start in a seated position. I'm just going to move the camera further away so that you can see the full body. Here we go. Starting in a cross-legged position. Exhale forwards. Stretching the hands forward. Inhale. Exhale, melt down a little bit more. Inhale. Walking the hands to the right-hand side. Placing the left hand onto the right hand, stretching the left side of the body. All the way to the left hand side, placing the right hand on the left hand, stretching the right hand body. Placing the right elbow down, reaching the left arm over. You can start making your fingers like a little spider, and if with each out breath, just taking it down a little bit more, and then making sure that the left butt cheek stays on the mat. Inhale and exhale. And then making the left hand heavy, coming forward, going through the middle, then placing the left elbow on the mat and reaching the right arm over, opening the right ribs. Again, if it's too deep, just each out breath, moving a little bit deeper. Going through the middle. And now just in your own time, find free movement, making your head heavy. Feeling the lubrication in your lower back. And then coming to all fours. Doing some cats and cows. Letting the udder tickle the grass. Arching the back. Reaching the heart center forward. Exhale. Tucking the tailbone and reaching the back of the shoulder blades up. Tucking the chin. Inhale.
Inhale.
The tailbone.
Cat. With a nice angry cat. To a straight spine, reaching the right arm forward and the left foot back, creating balance, and then tucking the chin so that the back of the neck is straight. And the right foot back. Reaching the right arm forward, left foot back, bending the left, and then kicking into the right hand with the left foot, creating a delightful arch in the back. Exhale, back to tabletop, reaching the right hand forward, the left hand forward, the right foot back, bending the right knee and kicking into the left hand, creating a delicious arch in the back. Top. And then reaching the right arm up, threading the needle through the left, placing the right shoulder onto the mat, the right ear, and then creating a very stable place with the ear and the shoulder so that the left hand can move forward and the right arm is almost in between, halfway between the left hand and the left knee, so that you can comfortably raise the left foot, tucking the toes, and then placing the left hand behind. And then making sure that your foundation is nice and strong, start kicking up the right leg. My left and right was completely wrong now. Lovely. And then when you're ready, bending the right leg and grabbing the right foot. Solid foundation. Kicking into the left hand with the right. No? Yes. Left. Placing it back down. Inhale, reaching the right arm up, and exhale, placing it down. Inhale, lifting the left arm up, exhale, threading the needle. Bringing the foot back down, placing the reaching the left arm up and placing it back down. Lovely. Rotate away. Placing the fingers towards the knees. Tucking the toes and then reaching back so that with the fingers facing outwards. Wrist. This is delightful. And then just coming back onto your knees. So that the chaturangas and the downward dogs aren't too painful. And then reaching the hands forward, turning the backs of the palms to face each other. The right arm underneath the left. Clasp the hands, bring them in like a cook sister,
And then just bounce it and feel how the wrists are warming up there. Lekker. And then the left hand underneath the right, grasping the fingers, bringing it through and bounce it. Coming to the top of your mat. Here we are, in your mountain pose. Slightly apart, reaching the arms up and exhaling forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. And exhale, stepping back to plank. Knees, chest, chin. And coming up to baby cobra. And then try and hover the hands. The backs of the feet are on the mat. And exhale, tucking the toes, reaching back into child's pose. And then into your first downward facing dog. Bending the knees and then rotating the body to the right. Oh, delightful. Inhale. Bending the knees to the left. Twist. Inhale. Then reaching the right leg up and then stepping it forward next to your right hand. Dropping the left knee, untucking the left toes, and coming to your low lunge. And as you exhale, clasping the hands behind the back and reaching them down. Toes, reaching the right foot back. Your vinyasa. Inhale into plank. Exhale, knees, chest, and chin. Inhale, baby cobra. Exhale, child's pose, and downward facing dog. Lifting the left leg up. Exhale, placing it next to the left thumb, dropping the right knee, untucking the right foot, inhale, and exhale, low lunge. Try and sink a little bit deeper. And always remember to keep your shoulders away from your ears, inhale, and as you exhale, clasping the hands behind the back, and then reaching down, opening the heart center, keeping the chin tucked, or gazing slightly up, whichever is most comfortable for your neck. Exhale, framing the front foot, tucking the back toes, and lifting back into a three-legged dog. And then downward facing dog. Inhale, fold, inhale, halfway lift, exhale, forward fold, and then going through your vinyasa, and this time into a chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog, and exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, right leg up, exhale.
Warrior two. Over, and that it's not coming in, that it's facing out, and that you're tucking your tailbone, and then just checking that arm is in alignment. I'm gazing over the front hand, inhale, reaching forward, exhale, reverse. Next to the right foot, reaching the left arm up into side angle pose. Cartwheeling the hands down and going through your three. Inhale, lifting the left leg up, exhale. Inhale, placing the left foot next to the hinge. Exhale, warrior two. One, tucking the tailbone. Inhale, lifting the right leg up. Exhale, right. And then going through your vinyasa. Three-legged dog, placing the left foot outside the left hand into your runner's lunge. Just moving forwards and backwards, lubricating the hip joint. You can stay here where you go down onto your elbows, or maybe you take a mile. Three-legged dog, exhale, downward facing dog, inhale, right leg up, exhale, placing the right foot next to the right thumb, inhale, high lunge, exhale, clasping the hands behind the back and reaching them down. And exhale, left hand forward, right hand back. Exhale, right hand down to thigh, left arm up. Exhale. Three-legged dog. Up.
balance pose. Placing your weight on your left hand side. Taking your right arm underneath the left. Bending the knees, right leg over the left. Coming into your eagle pose. To create a straight line. And placing the weight on the right hand side, left arm under right, bending the knees, left leg over right. Finding your drishti, looking at a place that doesn't move, finding your balance. And you hear the tree sways from one side to the other. Down and reaching up. Left leg into the right thigh. To twist a chair and while you're here coming onto the tippy toe the other side.
fingers.
Just ending in Savasana, lying on your back, falling forward, and I will just end the session. Lovely alternate nostril breathing. Placing the middle finger and the other finger onto your frown and using the thumb and the pinky to close the nostrils. So we're going to start closing the left nostril. Inhale through the closing the right nostril, breathing in through the left. Holding. Exhale through the left, the right. Holding. Inhale through the right. Holding. Exhale through the left. Holding. holding. Inhale through the right.